In part 3 of our lesson on products and quotients of complex numbers, you will learn how to convert complex numbers to trig form and then apply the product and quotient rules. In this example, we are given two complex numbers in rectangular form. Z1 is 3i and Z2 is radical 3 plus I. In order to apply the product and quotient rules, we must first convert each number to trig form. So let's take them one at a time. We know that Z1 is equal to 3i, which is the same as 0 plus 3i. Let's make a little picture. We know our x value will be 0 and our y value will be 3. Here is z. Looking at the picture, we can see that R1 is going to equal 3. And if you weren't sure, you could do the calculation. You know that R1 would be the square root of its x value, 0 squared, plus its y value, 3 squared, which would equal the square root of 9, which of course is 3. Also pretty easy to see in the picture that theta 1 is equal to 90 degrees. So then Z1 in trig form is equal to 3 cis 90 degrees. Let's take a look now at Z2, which is equal to radical 3 plus I. We can make its picture. We will go radical 3 in the x direction and 1 in the y direction, and there is z. We'll have to find r2 and theta 2. So r2 is going to equal the square root of its x value, which is radical 3 squared, plus its y value, which is 1 squared. That's equal to the square root of 3 plus 1, which is radical 4, which is 2. Tangent of theta 2 is y over x, which is 1 over radical 3, and if we rationalize that, we get radical 3 over 3. So looking at our special angle chart in the tangent row, we go up to find out that theta 2 is going to equal 30 degrees. So that means that Z2 in trig form is going to be 2 cis 30 degrees. Now that we have Z1 and Z2 in trig form, we can apply the product rule and the quotient rule. Z1, Z2 is equal to R1, R2, cis, theta 1 plus theta 2. That's going to equal 3 times 2, cis, 90 degrees, plus 30 degrees, which is equal to 6 sis 120 degrees. And this would be the trig form of the answer. To put it in rectangular form, we expand out the trig form and we get 6 times the quantity cosine of 120 degrees plus I times the sine of 120 degrees. Which is equal to 6 times, let's make a quick picture of 120 degrees. We know that 120 degrees is in quadrant 2, and the reference angle would be 60. So if we go to our special angle chart, in the 60 degree column, go down to the cosine row, we see that the value will be 1/2, and in quadrant 2, cosine is negative. Plus I times, in the 60 degree column, the sine row is rad 3 over 2, and in quadrant 2, sine is positive. So we get positive radical 3 over 2. Distributing, we get negative 3 plus 3i radical 3. And this is the rectangular form. Z1 over Z2 is equal to R1 divided by R2 sis theta 1 minus theta 2. So that's going to equal 3 divided by 2 sis 90 degrees minus 30 degrees. Which is equal to 3/2 sis 60 degrees, and that's the trig form of our answer. To get the rectangular form, we simply expand out the trig form. So we have 3/2 times the quantity cosine 60 degrees plus I sine of 60 degrees, which is equal to 3/2 times, well, reading right off of our special angle chart, the cosine of 60 is 1/2 plus I times the sine of 60 degrees, which is radical 3 over 2. Expanding that, we get 3/4 plus 3i radical 3 over 4. And this is the rectangular form. And if you like, it would also be okay to write this as one rational expression, so an equivalent answer would be if you wrote that Z1 over Z2 was equal to 3 plus 3i radical 3 over 4. That would be fine as well.